या हेलो, शैल वी स्टार्ट? ओके, नाउ यू सी नेक्स्ट कार्बाइड्स. ओके, ऑन दिस इन जेई दे हैव आस्क्ड क्वेश्चन लाइक कपल ऑफ टाइम्स. ओके, राइट डाउन इन दिस. इफ यू लुक एट द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ कार्बाइड्स हियर, लिथियम इज द ओनली मेटल अमंग अल्कली मेटल्स विच रिएक्ट्स डायरेक्टली विथ कार्बन एंड फॉर्म्स कार्बाइड्स ऑफ Li2C2 टाइप. Li2C2 type carbides, direct reaction. Okay, this carbide is ionic. Other metals forms carbides, but they do not react with directly with carbon. Like you see, if you talk about sodium, sodium reacts with acetylene to form carbides, which is Na plus C triple bond C minus minus Na plus. Okay. One more important reaction is what? This is the salt of acetylene. And when you dissolve this in water, it converts into hydroxide, NaOH, two molecules of it. And we get acetylene back. Done. Lithium reacts directly with carbon to form carbides because of the high lattice energy of lithium carbide. Right. Both cations, if you see Li plus and C2 2 minus, both cations are anions are very small. And hence they have a very high lattice energy. Because of that only it forms. Okay, so you must remember this. Lithium, again, you see the first element has abnormal properties. Lithium is the only alkali metals which reacts directly with carbon and forms carbides. Okay, so this is one important reaction. Li2C2 ionic type of carbide it forms. High lattice energy because of the small size of carbocation, sorry, cation and anion. Okay. Now, the another compound we have, that is carbonates and bicarbonates. So write down next. Carbonates and bicarbonates. Write down alkali metals forms carbonates of M2CO3 type, carbonates of M2CO3 type, and if you look at the reaction, how this carbonate forms, like for example, if you talk about Li, we can also form this with halide, like LiCl plus Na2CO3. It converts into 2NaCl plus Li2CO3. Or we can also have hydroxide, LiOH, 2LiOH in fact, plus CO2. So it forms Li2CO3 plus H2O. We can also obtain carbonates by the dissociation of bicarbonates. NaHCO3, when you heat this, we're talking about bicarbonates also here, carbonates and bicarbonates, we write down. So when you heat this bicarbonate, NaHCO3, 2NaHCO3, in fact, it forms Na2CO3 plus H2O plus CO2. So by heating bicarbonates also, we can get this. Preparation of bicarbonate, you see, will take hydroxide, NaOH, and this hydroxide, we allow this to react with CO2. It forms carbonates Na2CO3 and H2O. And this carbonates, we again circulate carbon dioxide into this. Like for example, the reaction is Na2CO3 plus H2O, and we add CO2 here. It forms NaHCO3, 2NaHCO3. This is how the bicarbonate forms. Okay, so both reactions are important here for carbonates and bicarbonates. Write down one note here. Lithium does not form a solid bicarbonates. Lithium does not form a solid bicarbonates due to its less electropositive nature. Okay, if you compare the stability of bicarbonates, like you see, write down, the stability of bicarbonates of, first we'll see carbonates, the stability of carbonates and bicarbonates increases down the group. Okay. Why it happens, I'll tell you. First of all, write down the order. We have Li2CO3 is less stable. Then Na2CO3. Then we have K2CO3. RB2CO3, CS2CO3. This is the order we have. Electropositive, why this happens? Because as we go down the group, you see, top to bottom, electropositive character increases. Electropositive character increases. When electropositive character increases, means tendency to form electropositive ion is more, and that will stabilize the carbocation. sorry, the carbonate ion, CO3 2 minus ion, will stabilize it, right? So write down, as we go down the group, the electropositive character increases, and hence the stability of carbonate also increases. As we go down the group, the stability, the electropositive character increases, and hence the stability of carbonate also increases. Okay, see, there are multiple factors here. If you look at this compound, these carbonates, and if you consider the size here, bond length, so as we go down the group, the size increases, bond length increases, bond length increases, so stability should be less. But that is not the factor here. The factor is not size, but the factor is electropositive character, because both are contradictory to each other. One is electropositive character and other one is size, the bond length. Both are contradictory. According to bond length, Li2CO3 should be the most stable one. According to electropositive character, it is ulta, right? Reversed, exactly reversed. So since both are contradictory to each other, so in such cases, the result becomes experimental. It depends upon which factor is the dominating factor. Okay. And in the book, the answer that is given, the order that is given according to the dominating factor only. Okay. So here we can say on the length or the size of the ions here, that is cation basically, electropositive character dominates over the size of the ion. And hence we have the answer according to the electropositive nature, which is this given here. Right, so this kind of thing will be there in inorganic chemistry. Once one particular logic gives you one particular answer, another logic gives you another answer. Okay, so you should know this fact, that at what point what logic is dominating, what logic prevails, and according to that only we can write down the answer. Okay, so here you need to think about the electropositive character, not the size over here. Okay, right. One more thing you can understand over here, carbonate ion is a big ion, right? The size of carbonate ion is large, CO3 2 minus. So one logic we also have here, that bigger anion or cation is stabilized by, so suppose you have bigger anion. So bigger anion is stabilized by bigger cation, and bigger cation is stabilized by bigger anion. Okay. So CO3 2 minus, this negative charge, is stabilized by the bigger ion that we have. And among this, you see CS plus is the biggest ion we have. That's why CsCO3 is the most stable one. Okay. Write down, these carbonates are highly stable towards heat, except Li2CO3. Okay, again, you see the change we have for Li2CO3. Again, abnormal behavior, right? All carbonates are what? Stable towards heat, but not Li2CO3. Li2CO3 easily decomposes into its oxide and CO2. Right? So Li2CO3 is easily decomposable when you heat this into Li2O and CO2. But all other carbonates are relatively more stable. Okay, quite stable. Next. These carbonates are soluble in water. These carbonates are soluble in water. and solubility increases as the size increases. Size of cation. Solubility increases as the size increases. If you look at the reaction here, M2CO3 plus H2O, it forms hydroxide MOH plus H2CO3. This is alkaline in nature. Base we have, no, alkaline. That's why we also say aqueous solution of carbonates is alkaline in nature. Okay, aqueous solution of carbonates are alkaline. Okay. Next point, write down. Except lithium, all other metals forms, except lithium, all other metals forms solid bicarbonate. Solid bicarbonate, and these bicarbonates are soluble in water. Okay. Fine. Now, next, write down. We'll see few properties of lithium, which we call it as abnormal behavior of lithium. Heading, write down. Abnormal behavior of lithium. Okay. Why it shows abnormal behavior? The reason is small size . So these are the reasons for this behavior, that is abnormal behavior. Small size, okay, and high polarizing effect. All these are because of small size only. High polarizing effect. Least number of electron. Electrons in the inner shell. And maximum ionization energy. So all these factors we have for abnormal behavior of lithium. What are the abnormal behaviors, properties? Okay. So first property here, write down. It is like it forms nitride of L3N type on direct reaction with nitrogen. with nitrogen. Okay. Nitrate, if you talk about LiNO3, lithium nitrate, when you heat this, it gives a mixture of NO2, O2, and Li2O. Okay. But if you have any other metal nitrates, for example, we have the valence reactions 4LiNO3, we have 4NO2 plus O2 plus 2Li2. When you look at the nitrate of other metals like NaNO3, and when you heat this, it forms, from nitrate, it forms nitrite, that is NaNO2, and O2 releases. So you see here, both are nitrates only, lithium nitrate and sodium nitrate, but this gives nitrogen dioxide. This does not produce nitrogen dioxide. It does not form nitrite here. It forms oxide, but it forms nitrite, sodium nitrite. Okay, one very important reaction you write down here. Lithium, when heated with NH3, when heated with NH3 forms imide. Okay, forms imide. So Li with NH3, it forms imide, 2Li we have. It forms Li2NH, NH plus H2. This we call it as imide, the general name, lithium imide or simply imide. But any other metal if you have, for example, if you take Na you heat with NH3, it forms amide, that is NaNH2, sodium amide. Okay, NaNH2. So imide lithium forms, it forms amide. One last point you write down. Bicarbonates of lithium is known in solution. Solid bicarbonates, lithium does not form. Okay, always keep that in mind. Bicarbonates of lithium is known in solution, but bicarbonates of other metals are known in solid state. Done. Bicarbonates of lithium is known in solution, but other bicarbonates are known in solid state. Okay. Now, there are a few compounds of sodium that we need to discuss. So, write down the heading, compounds of sodium. compounds of sodium. There are a few compounds of sodium. You should know the formula of this, like the common name, one we have chili saltpeter. Its formula is NaNO3, sodium nitrate. Cryolite, what is the formula of cryolite? Na3AlF6. Glauber's salt. The formula is Na2SO4. It is a decahydrated form of sodium sulfate, .10H2. If you write exams like, you know, some CET, BITSAT, okay, Manipal and all, they'll ask these questions, that what is cryolite? What is the formula of cryolite? Okay, like this. Glauber's salt. Another one is soda feldspar. Soda feldspar is NaAlSi3O8. Soda feldspar. Next one is borax. Borax is an important compound. Na2B4O7.10H2O. We'll discuss this again in boron family, that is group 13 elements. Borax, we also call it as tincal. Same name. Tincal is nothing but, in Hindi we call it as suhaga. That's the Hindi name. Okay, borax, tincal, in Hindi it is suhaga. S-U-H-A-G-A. Done. Okay. Next, you see the preparation of sodium. Two methods we have for this. We have two methods for this mainly. First one is Kastner's process. See, as far as preparation is concerned and the properties that we discussed, the order and all of carbonates, bicarbonates, okay, halides, what kind of halides it forms, hydroxides, okay, oxides, stability order, bond length and all those things, the order part that we discussed, those things are more important in this. Okay. It's not like they do not ask question from properties part, but if you look at the relatively, if you look at the importance, okay, those kind of order and the reasons for a given order. Okay. Those things are more important here. In Kastner's process, what happens? Okay. Give me a second here. Okay, fine. So in this, what you do, we'll discuss about the compound first. Just you wait for this. We have a compound here of sodium, that is sodium hydroxide. Means those compounds that I have given you, like cryolite, blubber salt, chili salt, pitrinol. For that, you just need to know the formula. Okay, there's no preparation and all. Just you need to know the formula. Other compounds like sodium hydroxide, the preparation is important. Okay, so other compounds you write down sodium hydroxide. First we finish this. Okay, sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide, we have 2-3 methods of preparation. Like the first one we have, we call it as causticization process. The preparation method, we have causticization. Process. We also call it as Gosse's process. G-O-S-S-A-G-E, Gosse's process. Not much important. We'll just write down 2-3 points here. Okay. So in this, what happens? Causticization process. Write down. This process involves the reaction between sodium carbonate and slaked lime. Sodium carbonate and slaked lime. Very simple reaction. We take 10% Na2CO3. Na2CO3. And this is allowed to heat with CaOH whole twice. It forms hydroxide NaOH plus CaCO3. This. Okay, the next method of preparation we have, electrolytic process. Electrolytic process. Write down. Write down nowadays, sodium hydroxide is prepared by the electrolysis of aqueous solution of sodium chloride. NaCl. The biggest advantage of this process is what? We get very pure NaOH. Means in comparison to the other method, we get purer form of NaOH. Okay, impurities are very less. Okay, we also get hydrogen and chlorine as the byproduct, which is also a valuable product. Like hydrogen and chlorine also very useful products we have, which we get here as a byproduct, which is also very useful, right? So right down in this process, we get H2 and Cl2 as a byproduct. Now, could you tell me aqueous solution of NaCl means what? If I ask you aqueous solution of NaOH, could you tell me, sorry, NaCl, could you tell me what all ions are present in this solution? Yes, aqueous solution of NaCl means what? What all ions are present? Yes, we have Na plus. We have Cl minus. H plus. And OH minus. Okay. Okay, so if you look at the overall reaction here, the overall reaction is we have NaCl plus H2O, simply it forms NaOH plus H2 plus Cl2. This is the reaction we have. How this reaction happens, if I write down the ionic equation here, the ionic equation is 2Na plus 2Cl minus, then we have 4H plus, or simply H2, I'll let it be as it is only. This is the reaction we get. Chlorine evolves at anode. This comes out at anode, and hydrogen evolves at cathode. See, if you try to understand the process of electrolysis, it's very simple. I'll explain you here what is electrolysis. In electrolysis, what happens, we'll take this iron in a container. We'll have a setup over there, right? So we have a container. Roughly, I'm drawing this. Don't draw this, okay? In this container, we have two electrodes present, right? And here, yes. So we have a container. In this container, we'll take the solution which we need to electrolyze. Means in this solution, we have all those ions present, Na plus, Cl minus, H plus, and OH minus, okay? These two are electrodes, correct? Now what we do, we connect these electrodes with an external source of current, battery, okay? So this is the positive end of the battery, this is the negative end of the battery. This rod becomes positively charged because it's connected to the positive end. And this becomes negatively charged, connected to the negative end. Correct. So when there is charge on the electrode, then these electrodes attract the oppositely charged ion towards its side. For example, this positive electrode, this will attract the Cl minus ion and OH minus ion towards this side. It will attract both. So both ion will go towards the electrode and try to get, you know, oxidize or reduce over there. Okay. Similarly, this negative ion also attract Na plus and H plus towards this side. So both Cl minus and OH minus is going towards this electrode, but the oxidation, this is obviously it is anode. So anode, we know oxidation takes place, and this is what? Cathode, at cathode reduction takes place. But it's not like that both ion, Cl minus and OH minus, will get oxidized over here. Oxidation of only one ion possible, and that depends upon the oxidation potential of that particular ion. The one which has higher oxidation potential has high tendency to get oxidized. Okay, these things in detail you will study in electrochemistry in class 12, right? What I am telling you here, both will compete with each other, but only one will get oxidized. Na plus and H plus, similarly, both will compete with each other, but only one positive charge ion will get reduced. Okay, so here what happens at anode, oxidation of chlorine takes place, because the oxidation of chlorine is easier than to that of OH minus. The two Cl minus get oxidize, converts into Cl2, and electron releases. Okay. Similarly, at cathode, what happens? Na plus and H plus. H plus will get reduced because at cathode reduction takes place. 2H plus will take 2 electron, converts into H2. Hence, you see hydrogen and chlorine gas evolves in this reaction. So they also ask this question that chlorine evolves at which electrode? So chlorine at anode, hydrogen at cathode. We have Na plus and OH minus ion, which combines and forms sodium hydroxide. Understood? Any doubt in this electrolysis? Okay. So this is done in electrolysis. For electrolysis, we have two types of cell, which we are not going to discuss. I'm just writing down the name. Nelson diaphragm cell. It is not at all important. Okay, just ignore this one. Second one we have, Kastner-Kellner cell. Okay, it is given in NCRT. If you want, you can just go through once. Kastner-Kellner cell. Okay, just go through once. The entire process is this only. Just we have here some cathode anode. There are two compartments in this. It is given in NCRT. So let's read this out. Okay, the logic is this one. Yes. So this is the preparation methods of NaOH, that is sodium hydroxide. Few properties of sodium hydroxide will finish today. Okay, we have few more minutes, we'll do it. So write down the properties next. Write down, it is soluble in water, highly soluble in fact, soluble in water, and this process is exothermic, releases large amount of heat. NaOH decomposes into its elements at high temperature around 1300 degrees Celsius. To Na plus O2 plus H2. To Na plus O2 plus H2. Correct? Okay. Few reactions of acid, write down reaction with acid and acidic oxides. So for example, you know this reaction is very simple. NaOH plus H2SO4 or HCl. Na2SO4 plus H2O. Okay, salt plus this, dibasic acid here. Acidic oxides, for example, if you take carbon dioxide, NaOH, CO2 is a acidic oxide. It forms, you know, it forms Na2CO3 plus H2O. Reaction with non-metals, you see. You can balance the reaction. Okay. Here also you can balance the reaction. Balance reaction I do not write always, right? I just write down the reaction. Okay. Reaction with non-metals. This reaction is also not balanced. Is it fine now? No. If I multiply this, I have to do it. No. The 2H4. 4 sulfur is 1, sulfur is 1, oxygen is balanced, 2 NaOH, CO3, H2O, it's right. Reaction with non-metals. So there are a few reactions which is important here. Like you see this, 2 NaOH, this one is important, 2 NaOH plus Br2, it forms NaBr plus NaOBr, I'm sorry, NaBr plus NaOBr plus H2O. This reaction you see, 6 NaOH plus Br2 gives 5NaBr plus NaBrO3 plus 3H2. You see two different reactions with the same reactant. The difference in these two reactions are this NaOH is cold and concentrated, but this one is hot and concentrated, and that is why it is important. Okay, with different temperature, we get different product here. Done. Yeah. Okay. Reaction with phosphorus here, you see. 3NaOH plus P4 plus 3H2O. When you heat this, it forms 3NaH2PO2 and PH3 evolves. PH3 is phosphine. Important. Phosphine evolves in this reaction. Write down next, it reacts with ammonia salt. Ammonia salt and ammonium salt basically, and releases ammonia. For example, ammonia salt, we have NH4Cl. Okay. So NaOH plus NH4Cl, it forms, obviously it forms NaCl plus H2O plus NH3. Ammonia releases in this with all ammonia salt. Similarly, you see reaction with metal, the last one, the reaction with metals. With zinc, you see Zn plus 2NaOH, it forms sodium zincate. Sodium zincate is Na2, ZnO2, H2 releases. Sodium zincate. With aluminium, 2Al plus 2NaOH in presence of water, it forms 2NaAlO2 plus H2. This compound is sodium meta-aluminate. If you take tin, then sodium is stannate. Two conditions here, the last two reactions. You see Sn with 2NaOH, it forms Na2 SnO2 plus H2. This is sodium stannate. If you again take here 2NaOH, it forms in presence of H2O, it forms Na2 SnO3 plus H2. This is sodium stannate. This is also possible when you take it as excess. Excuse me. So this is the two reaction we have here. So this is it for today. Okay, copy this down. I would request all of you for your assignment, hydrogen chapter, center module you finish completely. Okay, this is your assignment for the week. Center module, hydrogen chapter. Okay, and in this, only few things are left. Okay, I would request all of you to read NCERT for sodium bicarbonate. Okay, sodium bicarbonate. Read NCERT for same thing. We have some preparation and then some properties. Sodium carbonate, Na2CO3. NCERT for this. Okay, and that is it. In this, we have one Solvay ammonia soda process. That is important. Okay, so I want you to finish these two before the next class, because we'll be starting then alkaline arithmetic. Okay, have you done this slide, previous one? Yeah. Priyam, done? Okay, fine guys, so finish the assignment. Okay, see you in the next class. Take care, bye-bye.